Yes.
Perfect. All right. So let me share my screen. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So we'll be talking about the art of rocking your session. And, so that's the end result that we all expect, that you do the session. At the end, everyone gives you a standing ovation on about whatever you talk. So my name is Prasad Shirgaonkar. I have been a Drupaler since Drupal 4.6 days. That's I think around 2005. And have been working in Drupal and various capacities for last over 14 years now. Involved in hundreds of projects. Have been a part of almost 10 Drupal cons now. I had a session 5 years ago at Drupal con Amsterdam. Have been a part of almost all the camps, Drupal camps in India since 2009. Or definitely every camp in Pune. As well as a few camps in Mumbai, as well as Delhi. Currently, I handle the global certification program at Acquia. So I've been involved in the key team which built the Drupal certification. And I have been running the certification program. I'm audible, right?
Yes, yes.
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 Perfect. Okay. So the reason why we do these sessions for all the session experts or those who are going to conduct the session is the reason we observed that we have enormous amount of knowledge in our community in India. People are very knowledgeable, they are experts, they have worked a lot in Drupal, but when it comes to actually presenting your knowledge or doing a session, sessions don't become that interesting, or they sometimes get dragged on. Sometimes people don't know what to present, how to present it. And in spite of having a very good pool of knowledge, we actually lack in presenting. And that's why we started doing this session. So getting all the session holders together and just discussing about the do's and don'ts of doing in the session. But this is going to be an open discussion. I'm just going to put my thoughts and my observations and my recommendations initially. And then we can open this to discussion. So the first thing, let's ask like say 4 questions to ourselves before we do the session or do the presentation. So first thing, why are you presenting at the Drupal camp? So ask this question to yourself. So you submitted a session. So someone told you that there is a session at Drupal. There is a Drupal camp happening and they've invited entries. So you created some nice topic, some nice brief, and you put it online, and some a team of experts, they reviewed the, say possibly 50, 70 odd entries, and you got selected. So ask this question to yourself again, why am I presenting? So first of all, definitely you have been selected because your session sounds interesting. Second thing that you can be assured of is that you have been selected because now you have been say treated as an expert in this field in Drupal, or at least someone who knows something better than others. So that's one thing that to keep in mind, that you have been selected because you are knowledgeable, you are senior, or you are an expert in a particular topic of Drupal. So why are you presenting this topic? So obviously use this opportunity to build your own name in the community, your own brand in the community, as well as it's perfectly okay to build brand of the organization for which you are working. It doesn't mean that you have to keep on doing the marketing blurb all the time, but obviously give due credits to your organization, as well as your managers, as well as your teammates who helped you build your Drupal skill and Drupal knowledge. So you have been called because you are an expert. So use this opportunity to build your own name as well as your organization's brand. And third important thing, that why I'm presenting, is Drupal being an open source community and the way it is structured and grown, that's because people contribute, people give back to the community. So that's the last and main reason of presenting is giving back to the community. So in my presentation, whatever you are doing, whatever presentation you are doing, even participating in a Drupal camp, is actually being a very good and a responsible member of the Drupal community. So make sure that you use this opportunity to give back to the community and make our community even stronger by giving back your knowledge and your expertise to the community. So again, before doing the presentation, just brush up on these three areas that why I'm presenting. The second question to ask is, who's the audience? So who typically comes to Drupal camps? So typically in Pune, what we have seen is that we get about 350 to 400 participants in a camp, and majority of them are actually students. So those who are like new to Drupal, those who are curious about Drupal, those who want to understand and learn more about Drupal, that's about 70 to 80%, and remaining 20 to 30% are experienced developers, are community members who are already working in Drupal, but may not be like very high level of expertise, may be working for 6 months to a year, maybe a couple of years, and who want to know more advanced parts of Drupal. So understand who is the audience overall for the Drupal camp, as well as whatever topic you are proposing, out of those 400, who's likely to come to your session? Because I think multiple sessions run at a time, so people choose which session to attend, which session not to attend. So for you, is there some question? I'm hearing a
Parvatisham, can you mute your mic?
So find out, even for your session, who's likely to attend. Are they going to be, so in Drupal terms, we actually classify the audience into four different categories. One is called as a newcomer. The first level, which is like absolute beginner who doesn't know anything about Drupal, but who is curious about Drupal. That's the newcomer. The second level of audience is called as a learner. So someone who learns, who knows about Drupal, but who is still learning and who is still trying to get more and more knowledge. The third level of audience in Drupal is called as a skilled person. So a skilled is basically, yes, he has worked, say, 3-4 years in Drupal, and he knows a lot about Drupal. Maybe any one area, maybe just site building, maybe theming or backend development, or any one area, or all the areas. And the last level is the master. So to my particular session, who's likely to come more? So just think about that, so that you can tune your presentation to that extent. So if you know that for your topic, if you are doing something on, say, advanced caching system in Drupal, it's very likely that students may not come, but only, say, skilled people will come to your audience, to your session, to understand more about caching system. But if you are doing something about, say, the block system or the views in Drupal and how to build a specific types of views, then more likely that the students will come to your, the newcomers will come to your session. So make your presentation accordingly based on who's likely to come for your audience, or who your presentation is intended for. That brings us to the third question, which we should ask, is that whosoever is the audience, what is it that they really want to take away from my presentation? What is it that they should get, or they are expecting from my presentation? So the kind of synopsis that you had done for when you submitted the entry, really go through that synopsis again and really find out what's the real objective of your session. Say, what's one single line of takeaway from your session? So they should learn more about X. They should be able to see the demo of Y. They should be able to get motivated to download and do this module, or something of that. So sir, just to your own mind, define this objective, that what is it that you are going to give back to the audience in those 45 minutes. Because in that, really, you cannot do 10 different things. Broadly, you can give like either one broad area of knowledge or 2 to 3 sub areas of knowledge, but you cannot explain, say, the entire caching system of Drupal within 45 minutes, or you cannot explain the entire theming layer of Drupal within 45 minutes. It's impossible. So really jot down what is it that you really want to give as a takeaway of your session within that 45 minutes. And then your presentation should all be built upon how they can get what they are expecting, or how I can deliver this one liner objective within those 45 minutes. Because as I said, it's impossible to explain any even one system or subsystem of Drupal entirely within 45 minutes. But what you can really do is just take one small part and explain it really well, or show a very large picture and get people motivated to explore it on your own. So it's really impossible to show even how to write an entire module within 45 minutes, but you can show some very basic tips and then get them excited to do something on their own. So these are the broad high level questions that we should ask to ourselves for making our sessions effective. Once we do that, then it comes down to actually doing your presentation right and delivering it right. And here are some do's and don'ts for that. But before that, any questions on this part?
No, all good.
You're good? Okay. So let's go to the do's and don'ts of doing the presentation or conducting the session at the camp. So first thing about slides. So how many slides you should have in your presentation? They should not be obviously too few or too many. So if you have a 45 minute session, as a rule of thumb, should be around between 30 to 50 slides. Some people try to do it in like just 10 slides. That's fine. If you are able to talk for each slide for like 4 minutes, 5 minutes, that's perfectly fine. But if not, keep something about, just as a thumb rule, between 30 to 50 slides. That should be enough for a 45 minute session. Don't do too many slides, like 100 or 200 slides, because you just won't get time and you will have to skip through everything. The second important thing is about content on each slide. What exactly do you put on each slide? Some people just keep on writing lots of bullet points on each slide, and there is a lot of text to read. Remember, slides are not to be read. We will come to that in a minute also. But don't put too much content on the slide, because people don't get time to read. So just like this slide, just put the bullet points, not everything that you want to explain. Just the high level bullet points with some images, or just one big image which explains what you want to send, that's perfectly fine. But don't put a lot of bullet points and sub bullet points and tables and data to read. The third thing, which is design part, obviously be consistent with font and styles. You are projecting it on a wall somewhere. People are going to read it from distance. So it should not be like too small fonts. Just have like bigger fonts, consistent styles throughout the presentation. Use a lot of images because they convey the message nicely. If you are doing screenshots, make sure that they are readable. People can read what's there on the screenshot. Just take a glimpse of a screenshot rather than the entire desktop screenshot and all. If you are doing videos and screencasts, make sure that they are recorded well, they are edited, not a full 5 minute screencast of something which is happening, but maybe a glimpse of what's happening. So properly edited videos and properly edited screencasts. So make sure that your presentation and slides are really very pleasant, readable, and they convey the message within that presentation itself. The second thing, which is about code. So this is a technology conference, so you are going to present. Possibly some sessions will have a lot of code or code samples to be presented. So about code, just make sure that if you are putting code samples on the slides, it's impossible to read the entire code line by line, even if it's like a 50-line CSS file. It's impossible to read. So even if you put the entire code, people are not going to be able to read and understand that code from the slide. So just show the high level, top level, important parts of the code on the slides, not the entire code. Same is true about showing code samples in a text editor. So even if you open your code sample, in a session, basically, the purpose of these sessions, if you are not doing like a 3-hour training, but a 45-minute session, it's impossible to explain a 1,000-line code within those 45 minutes. So however great code you have written, even if you open it in a text editor and try to show people like how you have written the logic, people just won't get it. So just show the important part, important aspects of the code, how that is different, what are the most critical aspects of that code, highlighting those within either your text editor or within the slides. But showing entire code is not really recommended. And the last most important thing is that writing code during session is the worst idea. So people are there to understand what you want to explain about a particular topic. They are not there to see your coding skills. They are not there to see how fast you can type or how you can innovatively you can do a if-else loop or call a particular file or anything like that. So don't write code during the session. It's time wasting. Most of the times, because of your stress and because of the way you are conducting the session, the code fails. There are syntactical errors. So unless you are really doing a session about how to type faster or some techniques about writing code, don't write code during the session. Have it pre-written, pre-tested completely, and just show them the important aspects of the code if you want to show the code. So that's really important thing to remember. If you are doing a demo of, say, a certain theme or a certain module or a certain technology or certain thing that you have done in Drupal or your use case, that's perfectly fine. Just determine what's the purpose of your demo. Out of 45 minutes, how much time you want to give for the demo. Make sure for that, because some demos, even explaining a simple, 100 pages website can take 2 hours. If you keep on explaining what are the modules which are used, why they are used and things like that, it can take a lot of time. So really determine what's the purpose of the demo that you want to do. Does it really work? So make sure that it really works. Make sure that you really do the demo, keep on doing the rehearsals really well. Are you going to do it online or offline? Most of the times at conference places, the Wi-Fi is tricky, or it doesn't work, or it's shady, and something which you're really dependent on getting something from, say, GitHub and doing a automated test on some other site and deploying it in real time on some third site, it may not work. So make sure that it really works. Most of the times, make sure that whatever demo you have, there is an offline version as well, and you do the offline version on your own local environment rather than being dependent on internet. Just a practical tip. And of course, if you are doing a demo, make a rehearsal really well before the session, at least 2 to 3 times with your colleagues, with your friends. Just show that what you are going to do so that you can really do it really well at the time of the session. The next part is about your speech at the session. So the first and most important part is that when you are talking, don't read slides line by line. So that's a very bad way of presenting. People can read. So if you show something on the projector, people can read what's there. Again, you don't have to read it. So explain what's there rather than reading what's on the slide. So that's one very, very important part of the session. Become slow, deliberate, and audible. Make sure that when you start speaking, you ask people whether you are audible, whether they can hear you or not. Keep on getting the feedback about the audio part, about the video part. Make sure that they're understanding what you are saying. While explaining, while talking, use analogies, use stories, use examples, rather than just all the technical jargon and technical speech. Jokes are okay, but keep them within limit. Nowadays, people are very sensitive about jokes, especially if you venture into either political or religious type of jokes. People are very sensitive. That's not your purpose. You are not going to give a political speech here. So make sure that you are within the limits and keep the light environment, but don't get into any say controversies. Again, about speech, rehearse your speech. Stand in front of mirror. If you haven't done public speaking before, literally stand in front of mirror and talk for 45 minutes, or get your two or three friends together, talk in front of them, see how whether they can listen to you for 45 minutes or they fall asleep. But make sure that you are really effective. And always when you start the session, a smile, connect with the people and with the audience, and enjoy what you are doing over there, because that's why that's what this whole camp is all about. Plan your session in such a way that out of 45 minutes, in between also, after every 10-15 minutes, ask if everyone has any questions, and don't assume that there are no questions. Just wait for the same. Again, don't do a cliched joke like, okay, if there are no questions, which means that everyone has understood everything. That's a very cliched joke. So just ask, wait for the questions. If no one comes up within, say, 30 or 50 seconds, resume your speech. When someone asks a question, repeat the question, paraphrase the question, like put it in your own words, confirm whether that's what they want to ask, then answer that briefly and precisely. Don't disrupt the session flow. Sometimes there are some people who just keep on asking questions. After every 5 minutes, they will raise their hand and keep on asking the question. But if that's disrupting your session flow, that's not where you want your session to go. Just politely ask that person to, okay, let's keep those questions at the end. And now let me complete what I want to say, or whatever you are asking that will come in the session. If not, let's take it at the end. Keep some time, say 5 or 10 minutes at the end of the session for the real Q&As. And of course, be ready for whatever topic you have, you are presenting. Really read and understand that topic well, so that any questions that come on that topic, you are able to answer those on the spot, on extempore basis. And remember, it's perfectly okay not to know an answer. Don't bluff. Don't give wrong answers. Don't try searching over there. Don't argue with the audience. Say that, okay, I'm not aware. Let me find out. It's perfectly okay to not know any particular answer. And let's say that, okay, let's meet after the session and let's find the answer together. And that's a much better approach rather than giving a completely wrong answer as well. Okay, so any questions on this so far?
No.
Everyone's good?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
So there are some other etiquettes, obviously, while presenting. Obviously, keep all the chat windows off. You don't want, like, when you are presenting, someone to just some chat window to pop up asking you about what happened to last night's commit and all. Keep your desktop completely clean, especially if you have a habit of downloading torrents on the desktop. So make sure that your desktop is completely clean and is presentable, because that's what just pops up live in front of people. If you want to show sample files, don't struggle finding them because they are hidden somewhere inside the project folders. Make sure that whatever are the sample files, they are all neat and at a place where you can find them very easily. Keep your laptop fully charged so that it lasts for all those 45 minutes and you are not struggling for the power, but always still keep your power cord handy with you when you go to the session. Display connectors, if you're on Mac, make sure that you have converters and connectors ready with you. Don't depend that like someone will have it. Make sure that you have it handy so that you can do it. If possible, go before at least 5 to 10 minutes to the venue for your session. If the venue is open, make sure that you connect your laptop before you taste it in time, whether it's getting presented or not. Also, another tips which are not here is that keep a copy of your presentation in two different formats at least. So if it's in Keynote, also keep it in PowerPoint and a PDF file ready, because anything can happen. Anything can happen. Your laptop may not get just booted up, and like those copies on a pen drive or somewhere which are downloadable very easily. Your laptop may not boot up. It may not connect to the projector. The projector and laptops are not compatible. Anything can happen. So just keep a presentation handy in a different pen drive, so that you can just take someone else's laptop which is getting connected over there and start using your presentation. And again, why in two different formats? Because if you have done it in PowerPoint and that the other machine does not have PowerPoint, you should have a PDF handy so that you can at least start showing the PDF. You will not get disrupted. So keep it, just make sure that your 45 minutes, you are bang there, you start on time and you end on time. That's another thing to, very important thing to remember about Indian camps, is that make sure that at least from your side as a presenter, you are there on time and you try to start on time. You are there like 5 minutes before time at least, and you start the session right on time and end it right on time. Don't overrun, don't eat into other people's time. So just make sure that if you have 45 minutes, talk for 45 minutes and finish within that time only. So be a really professional person. So that's other etiquettes. That's all I had to share. So any open to take any questions, discussions, or anything that you have. Yes, guys.
I would like to say thank you, Prasad sir. The key points were very, very valuable. I have already presented one time before, but these points are really valuable to me this time as well. So I'll take care of these points which I have done before, like whatever the mistakes I have done before. So I'll try to improve that in this time, because your presentation is very helpful.
Awesome. Awesome.
Thank you.
Anyone else has any either feedback on this or questions, or do you find this valuable?
Yes. Hi, Praveen.
Hi, Praveen. Your voice is breaking.
Hi. This is my first Drupal camp. I present my session at my first. Hello.
Hello. Yes.
Hello.
Hi, Praveen.
Yes. Hi, sir.
So,
Praveen, can you please type in your question inside the chat window?
Oh, yes, sir. This is first Drupal camp. Your point. Okay.
Thank you. Nikita raised a hand. Nikita.
Yeah. Prasad sir, like you said, that we shouldn't be repeating we shouldn't be saying whatever there is written on the slide, but what if there are bullet points? I mean, in that case, can we just say whatever the bullet point is saying? Is that fine?
No, that's perfectly fine. What I said is that it really becomes boring. So, of course, you can say a bullet point and then explain like 2 or 3 sentences about it.
Yeah. Okay.
Read the bullet point and talk more about it. So, it's perfectly okay to do that, but not like write the entire paragraph and read that entire paragraph.
Got it. Okay. Thank you.
Chaitanya.
Yeah. So Prasad, do we have a Slido kind of thing for discussing the questions? Because if there are n number of questions for participants, then it will be difficult to answer every question.
Mm-hmm. So what's the question?
So can we have any kind of messenger or Slido so that they can bulk all the question and we can answer it at the end, so it does not miss anyone's question over there?
It's a great idea. Ajit, do we have any such arrangement?
We don't, because it's actually up to the speakers to decide how do they want to take questions. Like some prefer to do that while they talk, or some prefer to do that towards the end. So it's more of a speaker's preference.
So it will be fine, like if I create my own Slido at the time of my presentation. So
that should be fine.
Absolutely. Thanks. To try to use the technology, or go back to like the good old technology of using a blackboard and writing questions over there as and when they come. So.
Yeah. Thanks, Prasad.
So any other questions, guys? I think Praveen dropped. He was asking a question, but cool. So I'm glad that we are doing a Drupal camp again in Pune this year, and it's going to be a big one this time again. Pune camp is like one of the top three camps in India possibly, so congratulations to all of you for actually getting selected in one of the most prestigious camps in India, and let's rock this. So I'm sure that you guys will do really well. So we'll all be there, if you need anything from now until the camp, feel free to drop me a mail. You have my mail address from the invitation, or message me somehow. And all the best to you guys. And let's rock this camp as well.
Yes. Thank you. Yes. Thank you so much, Prasad. And thank you all for joining the call. There's just a couple of things I wanted to mention. So in the schedule, we have planned for a session for 55 minutes. That's keeping some buffer time in mind, as in you may speak up to complete 45 minutes, and maybe we can keep that 10 minutes for extra Q&A and for the next speaker to get in and make their arrangements as required. And we also have shared speaker resources in an email. You should have received those. If not, they are also hosted on the website. You can find the link from the footer. It contains template which we recommend using, presentation template. We recommend doing that because we are planning to record these sessions and put them online later. So it's better if every presentation has that specific format followed. Yeah. With that, if there are any other questions, now is the time.
So we are starting at 9, right, Ajit?
Yes.
Wonderful. So guys, see you at 8:45 on Saturday at VIT.
Yeah.